Hello everyone, this is Nagaraju Rebba. Today I am going to discuss basics in chemistry. You know that many of the students are facing the problems. Why? Because when they are learning the chemistry, they are facing the so many problems. So that's why by the overcome of that problems, simply in this episode I am giving the clarity about basic chemistry. So because of when they are learning the atoms and molecules and chemical bond and stoichiometry, chemical kinetics, atomic structure, whatever it. So if they are learning any lesson, so definitely these subtopics are repeating in the always. So therefore in this class I am saying these are subtopics. So now I am writing the board one by one, and after that I will explain the every one. So see here, just like the first one is called as a matter, and second one is called as a atoms, and the third one is called as a element, and the fourth one is called as a molecule, and the fifth one is called as a compound, and the sixth one is called as a valency, and the seventh one is called as a atomicity, and the eighth one is called as a symbol. So these are all the first phase. In the first episode I will discuss with you these are all the very very important subtopics, and then one by one I will explain clearly. So look at see here. So first one is called as a matter. I am saying the definition of the matter. Here you will see any material. Any material which has mass and occupies the space. See here, so the definition of the matter is any material which has mass. Any material which has a mass and occupies the space is called as a matter. Means I will give the one clarity about this matter. So in our surrounding we have the so many materials are there. In that all materials are compulsory contains the weight, and as well as the compulsory that materials are occupies the space. So suppose I am saying the examples of book, in our bag, in our water bottle, in our phone, in our bench, in our blackboard, whatever it, yourself also you are acting as a one of the matter. Why? Because we are contains the some weight, as well as we are occupies the some space. Suppose you see I am saying this is called as a chalk piece. So these chalk piece contains the some weight, and at the same time these chalk piece occupies this much of the space. So therefore if you are considering any material, that material compulsory contains the mass as well as it will occupies the space is called as a matter. So this is the definition of the matter and examples of the matter. And the matter is mainly classified into the two types, that is one is called as a physical classification. The matter is mainly classified into the two types. The matter is mainly classified into the two types. One is called as a physical classification. And the second one is called as a chemical classification. The matter is mainly classified into the two types. One is called as a physical classification, and the second one is called as a chemical classification. So these are physical classification is again classified into the five types. One is called as a solid materials, and the second one is called as a liquid materials, and the third one is called as a gaseous materials, and the fourth one is called as a plasma state, and the fifth one is called as a Bose-Einstein condensation. Bose-Einstein condensation. So see, these are physical classifications are again classified into the five types: solids and liquids, gases, plasma state, and Bose-Einstein condensation. And the physical classification also again classified into the two types. So one is called as a pure substances. One is called as a pure substances, and the second one is called as a mixtures. Again, you will see these few substances are again classified into the two types. So one is called as the elements. One is called as the elements, and the second one is called as the compounds. Second one is called as the compounds, and again these mixtures also classified into the two types. So one is called as a homogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures. And the second one is called as a heterogeneous mixtures. Heterogeneous mixtures. See here. The chemical classification is mainly two types. One is called as a pure substances and the second one is called as a mixtures. Here the pure substances are again classified into the two types. One is called as elements and the second one is called as a compounds. And coming to the mixtures, these mixtures also classified into the two types. One is called as a homogeneous mixtures and the second one is called as a heterogeneous mixtures. So this is called as a physical and a chemical classification of the matter. And now you can see I am explaining these physical classification here. And see, in the physical classification, just like we are seeing five types are there. Here the first one is called as a solids. So the materials which are present in the solid state in our atmosphere, they are all under the examples of the solid materials. Suppose you will see in our solid means the chalk piece, sand, in our pen, iron materials like aluminium materials, whatever it will take, which material is present in the solid state, that all are the under the examples of the solid materials. And the second one is called as a liquid materials. So liquid materials means generally you know that liquids means water molecule, next fluids, and next just like fruit juice, next all the solvents. So which solvents are there? They are all the under the examples of the liquids. And the third one is called as a gases. So gases gases matter generally you know that carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, next so nitrogen gas, hydrogen gas, oxygen gas. So they are all the under the examples of the in our gas state. So next one is called as a very important one, that is called as a plasma. So these are plasma. So the plasma is called as a ionized gas. Plasma is called as a ionized gas. So a plasma is called as an ionized gas, a gas to which sufficient energy is provided to get free electrons. Generally you know that so this is called as a gaseous material. In this gaseous material we will give the sufficient amount of energy. Sufficient amount of energy, why? Because these gaseous molecules are contains the both atoms or molecules. Atoms are molecules. So these are both atoms or molecules are so just like here you see atoms means it will contains the ions. And at the same time, this one contains the electrons. So in the plasma state, so both ions and electrons both are coexist with each other. In the plasma state, both ions and electrons both are the coexist with each other. So therefore, finally, I am giving the one clarity about the plasma. So plasma is nothing but an ionized gas. Ionized gas means if you take one material, so if you give the heat energy, what will happen means that gas molecules are going into the higher energy state. So then here just like that atoms are contains the ions as well as the electrons. Here the atoms and electrons both are coexist with each other. So therefore this one is called as a plasma state. So finally plasma state means it is nothing but a gas state. And coming to the next one is called as the Bose-Einstein condensation. So Bose-Einstein condensation, here I will give the clarity. So suppose you see here I am giving the clarity about a condensation. So condensation means it is nothing but a conversion of a. Condensation means it is nothing but a conversion. So conversion of vapor molecules into liquid molecules. So condensation means it is nothing but a conversion of a vapor molecules into liquid molecules. Therefore that is called as a condensation. Here you will see Bose-Einstein condensation. So Bose-Einstein is a condensator, superfluid phase. So it is called as a superfluid phase. Superfluid phase. Bose-Einstein condensation is called as a superfluid phase, which is formed by the atoms. Bose-Einstein condensation is a superfluid phase, which is formed by the atoms. So generally these atoms are cooled very near to the absolute zero temperature. And at the same time, these Bose-Einstein condensation is completely opposite of a plasma state. Why? Because here I give you the one clarity. Here the plasma means it is present in the ionized gas. This one is called as a gas state. And what about these Bose-Einstein condensation means these gas molecules are converting into a just like liquid molecules. So therefore, this is called as a clarity about in our plasma state and Bose-Einstein condensation. And next, I am going to discuss the atom. I am going to discuss next subatomic topic, subtopic, that is called as a atoms. So an atom is a smallest particle of an element. An atom is the smallest particle of an element. Or I am writing the one more definition of the atom. An atom is uncuttable. Uncuttable or undivisible. Uncuttable or undivisible. See, once again I am saying the definition of the atom. An atom is the smallest particle of an element. Another definition of these atoms is called as an atom is a uncuttable or undivisible. See, here I am saying the one example regarding these. Suppose this is called as a chalk piece. So these chalk piece contains so many particles. Like here I am saying the important point. So particles. Here you will see that's a very important term. Particles means it is called as a atoms or molecules. Particles means here. So just like they are all called as atoms or molecules or ions. So coming to the example, so a chalk piece contains so many chalk powder particles. We cannot separate every particle of the chalk because of it is nothing but very very small. And at the same time, I am saying here this is called as a so just like 50 grams of a salt. So in this 50 grams of a salt, can you separate every particle of the salt? Means it is very difficult. Why? Because which one we are taking, that one is called as a very 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 small particle. So that's why I am saying the definition an atom is called as the smallest particle of an element. And suppose here you see, I am saying this is called as one of the paper. By the tearing of this paper, you will see just like we are tearing the different pieces. Finally you will see, so this is called as a small particle and this is called as a small particle like that. And finally we will tear a very 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 fine particle. So again these very very fine particle we cannot break it. So therefore that's why they are saying that an atom is called as a smallest particle. So which one is the least means atom is called as a least. And at the same time that's why they are saying that uncuttable or undivisible. See, I am saying the atoms means just like I am saying the examples of the atoms are like here you see hydrogen atom. So atomic form is only single atom. And just like helium and simply you are writing that neon and like if you write the nitrogen. So these are all called as atomic form of respect to these elements. Atomic form of a respect to these elements. And finally, I'll give the one clarity about atoms means an atom is called as the smallest particle of an element. And at the same time, I'm saying the atom means it is called as uncuttable or undivisible. And coming to the next, so these atoms contain the sum of the subatomic particles. Therefore you will see what are the subatomic particles contains the atom means just like three. So one is called as a proton and the second one is called as a electron and the third one is called as a neutron. An atom is called as a small particle. So again these small particle contains the very very small particles. So the very very small particles are first one is called as a proton and the second one is called as a electron and the third one is called as a neutron. Here you will see I am saying just like this is called as a one of the atom. So I am considering this one is called as a one of the atom. So in this atom, so they are just like this one is called as a nucleus. I will give the clarity here. So this nucleus, what is that? Size of the nucleus is a very very smaller than size of the nucleus is a very very smaller than size of the atom. So means here you can understand So if you consider these nuclear charges colors, these nuclear sizes colors are very very less than the, so yes, what is the size of the atom? So therefore here I am saying that so these nucleus contains so two important terms. One is called as a proton and the second one is called as a neutron. If you see any atom, if you take any atom, that atom contains the three important fundamental particles or three important subatomic particles. The subatomic particles, one is called as a proton and the second one is called as an electron and the third one is called as a neutron. Here you will see, just like I am writing, this is called as a nucleus. In that nucleus, the nucleus contains both protons plus neutrons. And coming to here, just like I am saying that, so the protons are discovered by, generally the protons are discovered by the Goldstein. So actually, the positively charged particles are introduced or discovered. The positively charged particles are discovered by the, yes, what is that, Goldstein. So these protons are discovered by the Goldstein. And later, so the name proton was given by the Rutherford. The name proton was given by the Rutherford. And generally, these protons are symbolical representation is called as a positive. The protons are, what is the sign of the protons means a positive. And the symbolical representation of the protons are P. The symbolical representation of the protons are P. And coming to the electrons, so the electrons was the first discovered by the J.J. Thomson. The electrons was the first discovered by the J.J. Thomson. The electrons was first discovered by the J.J. Thomson. And what is the sign of the electrons means it is called as a negatively charged particles. So generally electrons are the negatively charged particles. The symbolical representation of the electron is a e power minus. The symbolical representation of the electrons is a e power minus. And the next one is called as a neutrons. So who discovered the neutrons means Chadwick, James Chadwick. James Chadwick. So James Chadwick is discovered by the neutrons. And what is the charge of the neutrons means neutrons does not contain any charge. Therefore we are writing that is called as a no charge. And next, what is the symbolical representation of the neutrons is called as a N. So see, once again I am saying that atom. So this atom is the smallest particle. So when comparing with the atom, which one are the very very small particles means just like protons, like these are all called as a subatomic particles. In that subatomic particles, first one is called as a proton and the second one is called as an electron and the third one is called as a neutron. And what I am saying that who discovered the proton means Goldstein. So Goldstein is given by the name of the positively charged particles. But later the name was given proton is Rutherford. And you will see here, so in the protons, just like what is the symbolical identification of the protons means the protons are contains the positively charged particles and the symbolical representation of the protons is a P. And coming to the electrons, electrons are generally discovered by the J.J. Thomson. So and next, so what is the sign of the electrons means it is called as a negatively charged particles. And what is the symbolical representation of the electron means e power minus. And the next one is called as a neutrons. Neutrons were discovered by James Chadwick. So generally neutrons are contains no charge and the symbolical representation of the neutron is a N. And see here, these all subatomic particles, which subatomic particle is the first discovered means, so generally the electron was the first discovered by the J.J. Thomson. The first discovered subatomic particle is called as a electron. And I am giving the very clarity here. So when compared with the atoms and these subatomic particles, which one contains the very least means, these subatomic particles are contains the very very least particles when comparing with the atom. So simply we are saying atom is smaller. So when comparing with the atom, which one is the very very small means just like these subatomic particles are very very small particles. And coming to here, just like I written here, so if you take if you consider any atom, so these atom contains the nucleus, like this is called as one of the nucleus. In that nucleus contains both protons plus neutrons. Now you can say these nucleus contains which charge? Here the protons are contains the positive charge and the neutrons does not contains any charge. So therefore here the nucleus contains the positive charge. The nucleus contains the positive charge and the electrons are always surrounded by the nucleus in a circular path. The electrons are always surrounded by the nucleus in a circular path. So therefore here you will see, if you consider any atom, that atom compulsory contains the three important subatomic particles and at the same time, so the atom compulsory contains the number of protons are equals to number of electrons. It's a very very important point. So why? Because if you consider this, so these are how many positively charged particles are present on the nucleus, that many negatively charged particles are surrounded attracted by the in our nucleus. Why? Because here the positively charged particles are always attracted by the negatively charged particles. Why? Because here the positive and negative. So here the positive sign and negative sign both are the attracted with each other. Positive sign and negative sign both are the attracted with each other. And at the same time, here the positively charged particles and negatively charged particles contains the some repulsive forces also. Some repulsive forces also. When compared with the attractive force and repulsive force, the repulsive forces are predominantly dominating on the attractive force. That's why here generally the nucleus contains the positively charged, and always the electrons are surrounded by the nucleus. And I'm saying the one important point here: if you take any atom, that atom compulsory contains the number of protons are equals to number of electrons. That's a very very important fundamental particle. Why? Because here I'm saying one atom. So like a hydrogen atom. So hydrogen atomic number is 1. 1 means it will contain the 1 proton and it will contain the 1 electron, but a different number of the neutrons. If you write any atom, that atom contains so number of protons are equals to number of electrons, but a different number of the neutrons. That's a very very important point. If you take any atom, that atom contains the number of protons are equals to number of electrons, but it is a different number of the neutrons. So therefore this is called as a summary about the atom. And coming to the next one, I'm saying elements. Next one, I am saying the elements. See here, I am writing the definition of the element. An element is a substance composed of one or more same atoms, one or more same atoms is called element. See here, I am saying the definition once again. Here very very important point, this one is called an element is a substance. An element is a substance, it is a one of the substance which is combined with, which is composed of one or more, it's a very important, one or more same atoms. One or more same atoms are called as elements. Here you will see I am writing the examples of the elements. Here first I am writing the example of the element here, H2. And here I am writing that N2. And here I am writing that O2. And here I am writing that P4. And here I am writing that S8. So like here, according to definition, what I am saying that an element is called as a combination of atoms. Like in this example H2, you will see it is nothing but a combination of hydrogen plus hydrogen. So in the formation of a H2, it will contain the two hydrogen atoms. It is the combination of the two hydrogen atoms. And the second one is called as a nitrogen. Here you will see, so it is the combination of the two nitrogen atoms. And in the case of a oxygen, it is also combination of the two oxygen atoms. And in the case of a phosphorus, so these phosphorus is nothing but a combination of the four phosphorus atoms. These P4 is nothing but a combination of the four phosphorus atoms. And here you will see S8. S8 means it is nothing but a combination of the S sulfur atoms. So therefore, simply we are saying this one is called as a. Just like element. See, once again I am saying that an element is a substance which is composed of one or more atoms. An element is a substance which is composed of one or more atoms. That atoms are compulsory same atoms only. Like that here you will see examples are written H2, N2, O2, P4 and S8. If you observe these all examples, I written as the same atoms. Like here you will see H2 means it is nothing but a combination of two hydrogen atoms, H plus H. And the nitrogen means N plus N. This is nothing but a combination of two nitrogen atoms. And O2 means it is nothing but a combination of two oxygen atoms. And here you will see P4 means it is nothing but a combination of four phosphorus atoms. And the next S8. S8 means it is nothing but a combination of 8 sulfur atoms. So therefore it is called as a combination of same atoms. And this is called as a very important of the element. And I am saying that next, based on the properties of an element, the elements are mainly classified into here. So simply you will see I am writing that as a classification of the elements based on the properties of the elements. These are classified into simply here you will see. So first one is called as a metals, and second one is called as a non-metals, and the third one is called as a metalloids, And the fourth one is colors here, noble gases. And the fifth one is colors radioactive elements. Radioactive elements, see here. What I am saying that based on the properties of the elements, these elements are mainly classified into the five types. That first one is called as a metals, and the second one is called as a non-metals, and the third one is called as a metalloids, and the fourth one is called as a noble gases, and the fifth one is called as a radioactive elements. See, just I will give the a brief introduction of these metals, non-metals, metalloids, and noble gases, and so what is that radioactive elements. So simply see, first one is called as a metals. So generally the metals are solid at room temperature. See here, I will give the brief introduction about these metals. So metals are generally solid at room temperature. And I am saying the very important point, in our long form periodic table, at present we have the 118 elements are there. In our long form periodic table, at present in our chemistry, we have the 118 elements are there. Out of these 118 elements are only, so helium, neon, and argon, krypton, and xenon, and radon. So these group elements only, stable group elements. In our out of 118 elements, so just I am writing here, this is called as a zero group elements or noble gases. These noble gases only showing as a stable electronic configuration. So because of these group elements are follows the octet rule as well as a duplet rule. I will explain later that octet rule and duplet rule. But here you will see most of the metals, metal atoms are called as a electron rich. They have the more amount of the electrons. That's why these metal atoms are readily to give the electrons to the neighboring bonded atoms. These metal atoms are electron rich. These metal atoms are readily to give the electrons to the neighboring bonded atoms. So that's why here you will see generally metal atoms are always loose of electrons. By the loose of electrons means these metal atoms are forming as a positively charged. These metal atoms are showing as a positively charged. See, once again I am saying that generally most of the metal atoms are the solid at room temperature. And I said that here in our chemistry we have the 118 elements are there. Out of these 118 elements, zero group elements are called as the stable electronic configurations. But remaining all elements does not follow the octet electronic configuration or stable electronic configuration. Why? Because they need the some amount of the electrons, or they have the some more amount of the electrons. So due to that instability, they are trying to getting the stability. So therefore, when the getting of the stability, they are loose of electrons, some are the gain of electrons. Here you will see the metal atoms are mainly solid at room temperature. And what is the second characteristic property of the metal atoms means, generally metal atoms are loose of electrons. By the loose of electrons, these metal atoms are always getting the positively charged. I will set one example and I will give the clarity about this. So sodium atomic number is 11. So by the writing of the electronic configuration of the sodium, 1s2, 2s2 and 2p6 and 3s1. So simply see, so these sodium atom contains the one of the extra electron. By the loss of this one extra electron, so immediately that sodium atom to forming as a Na plus. See here, this is called as arrow mark. Here I am writing that Na plus. So generally sodium is called as a metal atom. So these sodium is a loss of one electron, and immediately it is forming as a positively charged. So these positively charged indicating as a loss of electrons. And see here what I am saying, that generally metal atoms are always loose of electrons, and they are forming as a just like a stable electronic configuration. By the loss of these Na plus, here the sodium follows the octet rule. Sodium will follow the octet rule. So therefore this is called as a one of the main important identification of the metal atoms. And generally metal atoms are contains the some other properties also. So next, what is the other property means? Lustrous. Lustrous property. So lustrous property means it is nothing but a shining surface. Shining surface. Lustrous property means it is called as a shining surface. And just like you see, lustrous means it is nothing but a brightness. Suppose if you see just like iron ore or just like gold materials or silver materials, whatever it is. So when the light is passed on that materials, immediately that materials will give the brightness. That brightness here it is called as a lustrous. So lustrous means it is called as a shining surface. Generally, most of the metal atoms are following the lustrous property. And the next one is called as a just like metals are the good conductors of heat and electricity. good conductors of heat and electricity. So generally metal atoms are good conductors of heat and electricity. Why? Because just like most of the metal atoms are the solid at room temperature, so that's why these metal atoms are so generally good conductors of heat and electricity. And the most important properties, so generally all metal atoms are to follow the ductile property. Metal atoms are contains the ductile property, and the metal atoms are contains the malleable property. Malleable property. So means which solid material to follow, sir? So these properties are they are all called as the metal atoms. So generally, see, first I am saying the solid material. Generally, most of the metal atoms are the solid at room temperature, and the metal atoms are the lustrous at room lustrous. Lustrous means it is called as a shining surface. And the generally metal atoms are good conductors of heat and electricity. So next, metals are the ductile in the nature, and the next one is called as a malleability. And see here, I am writing that what are the examples of the metals. So here I am writing that examples of the metals. So generally iron, so symbolical representation of the iron. And next next one is called as a copper, and next one is called as a sodium and a potassium, and next one is called as a calcium, and next one is called as a aluminium. So like these are all called as examples of the metals. And second one is called as a non-metals. So generally non-metals are the so solids, liquids, gases at room temperature. Generally non-metals. Generally non-metals are non-lustrous, and non-metals are malleability and non-ductility, and generally non-metals are bad conductors of heat and electricity, except graphite. Graphite is a non-metal, but the graphite is a good conductor of heat and electricity. So that's why here the most of the non-metals are solids, liquids and the gases. And the next one is called as in our metalloid. Metalloids. Here you will see. So metalloids means the element which contains the element which exhibits both metallic character and non-metallic character. Both metallic character and non-metallic character. So the element which contains both metallic character and non-metallic character, that element is called as a metalloid. So simply you will see I am writing here the examples of the metalloids. So see what are the examples of the metalloids means here I am writing that the germanium, and the next one is called as a arsenic, next one is called as a antimony, and the next one is called as a bismuth. And the next one is called as a here just like a tellurium. Like these are all examples of the just like a metalloids. Metalloids means it is nothing but just like the element which exhibits. Exhibits means follows. The element which follows both metallic character and non-metallic character. So the element which contains the metallic character as well as a non-metallic character. So therefore this one is called as a just like a metalloid. Here the examples of the metalloids are germanium, arsenic, antimony, and next to bismuth and tellurium. Like these are all called as a examples of the metalloids. And the next one is called as a noble gases. So generally noble gases are the stable electronic configuration. They are not react with any other element. Why? Because they are the stable, they are following as a stable gas electronic configuration. See here I am writing that noble gases. Like in our chemistry we are saying that eighth group elements means helium, neon, next argon, krypton and xenon and radon are called as in our zero group elements. So these zero group elements are also called as a noble gases, and another name of these noble gases is called as inert gases. Why? Because we are calling that group elements does not react with any other elements. And what is the another name of these noble gases means aerogens. Aerogens also we are calling. Like that here you will see in this noble gases are follows the two types of electronic configurations. One is called as a duplet. So duplet configuration, and the second one is called as a octet configuration. So one is called as a duplet configuration, second one is called as a octet configuration. Here you will see duplet. Duplet means it is called as a the element which contains two electrons in their outermost orbit. The element which contains two electrons in their outermost orbit, that element follows the duplet electronic configuration. Here you will see I am writing that duplet means So generally that element contains the ns2 electronic configuration. ns2 electronic configuration in the outermost orbital. ns2 electronic configuration in the outermost orbital. So that element follows the Jupiter electronic configuration. Next one is called as an octet. Octa means in order, just like octa means 8. The element which contains 8 electrons in the outermost orbital. The element which contains 8 electrons in their outermost orbit, that element follows the octet electronic configuration. So simply we are writing the general electronic configuration of these octet is a ns2 np6 electronic configuration in their outermost orbit. The element which contains a ns2 np6 electronic configuration in their outermost orbit, that element follows the octet electronic configuration. So generally in our chemistry we are saying these two are the stable configurations. One is called as a duplet, second one is called as a octet. See here I am saying the examples of these duplet and octet. Here you will see just like helium, helium atomic number is a 2. By the writing of the electronic configuration it is called as a 1s2. Means this is called as an electronic configuration of the helium. So means helium contains the 2 electrons in their outermost orbit. And coming to the just like second one is called as a neon. So neon atomic number is a 10. So by the writing of the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2 and 2p6, so means this is called as the outermost electronic configuration. In this outermost electronic configuration, the neon follows ns2, np6 electronic configuration. This ns2, np6 configuration is called as a octet electronic configuration. That's why we are saying neon follows the stable electronic configuration, as well as that stable electronic configuration is called as octet. And helium follows the duplet electronic configuration. That's why we are saying that noble gases are called as a stable group elements in our long form periodic table. And at the same time, I will give the one important explanation. So just like remaining all elements are trying to get this stability, but these zero group elements are does not react with any other elements. And the next one is called as a radioactive elements. Next one is called as a radioactive elements. Radioactive elements. See here, radioactive elements means the elements which emit the alpha, beta and the gamma radiations is called the radioactive elements. Radioactive elements. See here, very very important. So radioactive elements means the elements which emits. Emits means it is nothing but a release. Emit means it is called as a here emission means it is nothing but a releasing. Emit means it is nothing but a releasing. The element which emits alpha and beta and gamma radiations is called as a radioactive emits. The elements which emits so just like alpha, beta and gamma radiations is called as a radioactive emits. So generally what are the examples of the radioactive elements? Here you will see uranium. So uranium is nothing but one of the best example in the radioactive elements. And the next one is called polonium, uranium, polonium, and next radon, and next ruthenium. Like these are all called as examples of the radioactive. So like see uranium, polonium, and radium. Uranium, polonium, and radium. So these are all called as the best examples of the radioactive elements. So this is called as a important concept of the in our elements. And the next one is called as the molecules. And the next one is called as a molecules. A molecule is a substance. A molecule is a substance composed of atoms of a same elements or different elements is called as a molecule. So generally here you will see a molecule is a substance composed of atoms of a same elements or different elements. Like here you will see I am writing the examples. Here the examples of the molecule like H2 is called as one of the example, and next here the carbon dioxide is also called as example, and here the water molecule is also called as example, and SO2 is also called as examples. Here you see, so just like a molecule is a substance composed of atoms of a same element. Atoms of a same element are different elements. Here you will see H2. H2 means it is called as the same element. Like the same atoms are combined. And in the case of a carbon dioxide, carbon is a different and oxygen is a different. In the case of a water molecule, here the hydrogen is a different and oxygen is a different. Therefore, I am saying here the molecule is the substance composed of atoms of a same element or different elements. And the next one is called as a compound. So next one is called as a compound. A compound is a substance. A compound is a substance composed of two or more different elements. Two or more different elements chemically combined with each other. Chemically combined. In a fixed proportion by weight. By weight is called a compound. See here I am saying the definition of the compound. Here a compound is a substance. A compound is a substance composed of two or more different elements chemically combined. A compound is a substance composed of two or more different elements chemically combined with each other in a fixed proportion by weight is called as a compound. Now I will give the clarity about this compound. You will see here. So if you consider any compound, that compound contains the two or more different elements. It is a combination of two or more different elements, and at the same time these different elements are chemically combined with each other. In a fixed proportion. That's a very, very important. In a fixed proportion by weight is called as a, just like a compound. See, I will give the one example regarding this compound. So like you see here, so just like I'm saying, what is the examples of the, so examples of these compounds, I'm writing that here. So examples of these compounds, water molecule and carbon dioxide, and next SO2, and next SO3, and so on. These are all called as examples of the compound. So water molecule, carbon dioxide, SO2, SO3, like that. These are all called as different types of examples of the compound. Here you will see, I am explaining the first example, H2O. Here you will see, I am writing the H2O. By the explanation of these H2O, water molecule contains the two hydrogen atoms. The water molecules contains the two hydrogen atoms, and it will contain the only one oxygen atom. So it will contain the only one oxygen atom, two hydrogen atoms. Here you will see the atomic weight of the hydrogen atom is 2. Why? Because every hydrogen atom atomic weight is called as 1. So therefore here the two hydrogen atoms are there, 2 into 1, 2. And next here you will see one oxygen atom is there here. So 1 into, just like oxygen atomic weight is called as 16. So then this is called as 16. So finally you will see, so what is the fixed proportion of the, so in a water molecule, just like the oxygen and hydrogen means it is called as a 2:16 ratio. In the 2:16 ratio means simply we are writing this is called as a 1:8. So 1:8 means if you write, if you see anywhere in our chemistry, so the carbon, so the hydrogen is called as a fixed proportion, that is called as a 1, and the oxygen is called as a fixed proportion, that is called as a 8. So therefore, once again you will see in our definition, a compound is a substance composed of two or more different elements chemically combined with each other in a fixed proportion by weight is called as a compound. Here you will see this called as a fixed proportion, means a fixed proportion by weight. Here you will see the weights of the hydrogen and oxygen anywhere in our chemistry. So they all contain the same, that is called as a 1:8 ratio. So therefore this one is called as a compound. And then you will see, I am explaining the next topic, that is called as a, in our symbols. So next subtopic is called as the symbols. So symbol means a shorthand representation of an element. Shorthand representation. Shorthand representation of an element is called a symbol. Shorthand representation of an element is called as a symbol. So shorthand representation means it is called as a simple form. Suppose you will see here I am saying the examples. So based on the examples, you will easily understand that. So you know that we are writing that ATM. So ATM means it is called as an automated teller machine. ATM means it is called as an automated teller machine. And then next you will see RBI. RBI means it is called as the Reserve Bank of India. Reserve Bank of India. And the next one is called as a CBI. CBI means it is called as a Central Bureau of Investigation. Central Bureau of Investigation. And next, if you write CID, CID means it is called as a Crime Investigation Department. Crime Investigation Department. See, here I am writing that. So ATM means it is called as an automated teller machine. Here, what is the automated teller machine? Short form means ATM. So why? Because by the writing of these symbol like ATM, so we by the pronunciating of that name ATM means always we are lose of some amount of energy, and at the same time it will take some time. So therefore instead of these loss of amount of energy and wasting of a time, simply we are writing the ATM. So why? Because always we can't say to our friends, hey, you are going to automated teller machine, you are going to automated teller machine. It is a difficult by the pronunciation. That's why we are saying that instead of that automated teller machine, simply we are saying that is called as a ATM. This is called as the simplest form of the automated teller machine. And at the same time, RBI, Reserve Bank of India. So Reserve Bank of India is nothing but a bigger name. So by the bigger name, by the pronunciation is very difficult. And by the writing of that name also, it will take the time. And we are loss of the amount of energy. That's why instead of that name, we are writing the RBI. You know that in our, so TSRTC. TSRTC. So means here you will see Telangana State Road Transport Corporation. Telangana State Road Transport Corporation. And you will see here the party TRS. And you will see TRS means Telangana Rashtra Samiti. TRS means Telangana Rashtra Samiti. Like that, it is nothing but a simple form of that big name. So like always we can't speak Telangana State Road Transport Corporation, because of by the pronunciation of that name it will take the more time. Instead of just like that bigger name, simply we are keeping the short name. That short name is called as a TSRTC, and just like TRS means Telangana Rashtra Samiti. Like that here CBI means it is nothing but a Central Bureau of Investigation, and CID means Crime Investigation Department. This is nothing but a shorthand representation of a element. So coming to elements, simply, so just like you know that by the writing of elements, you know that so what is the English name of the hydrogen means HYDRO, GEN. And next, what is the next one is the helium, HELIUM, helium. So by the just like writing of this name, so it will take the time. And by the writing of the name, just like a pronunciation of the name, it will take the time. And by the writing of the name, we will lose the amount of energy. So therefore, instead of these names, simply we are writing that symbol is called as a H. So in the English name, so the first letter we are keeping the symbol of that element. So therefore, what is the symbol of the hydrogen means H. And here, what is the symbol of the helium means, simply we are writing the two letters. One is called as a first letter and the second one is called as a second letter. So when we are writing, just like you will see, sometimes we are writing the sodium, spelling of the English spelling of the sodium. So therefore here, what is the symbolical representation of the sodium is Na. And next to potassium. Here you will see potassium, P-O-T-A-S-S-I-U-M, potassium. this is called as a English spelling. So therefore, simply we are writing the K. Here you will see sometimes we are writing, so just like two letters of the symbols. In that particular case, compulsory you must write the first symbol is called as a capital letter, followed by the second symbol is called as a small letter. So this is called as a one of the systematic writing of these symbols. Okay, and see here, just like next we are writing the sodium. So the symbolic representation of the sodium is called as Na. Here you will see the first letter always you must write the capital letter, that is called as a N, and followed by the second letter is called as a small letter, that is called as a A, and next one is called as a potassium. Potassium means K. Why we are writing here, the spelling of the sodium is called as a, just like sodium, it is starting with S, but the symbol of the sodium is called as a Na. Why? Because this sodium is taken from the Latin name, that is called as a natrium. So natrium spelling is called as a N-A-T-R-I-U-M. In the spelling of the natrium, first two letters they are taken as a symbol, that is called as a N-U-A. And next here also the potassium, the Latin name of the potassium is called as a calcium, K-A-L-I-U-M, calcium. In the spelling they are keeping the first letter, that is called as a, so just like first symbol, that is called as a K. So therefore next one is called as a, so gold. So you know that gold symbol is called just a spelling of the gold, so G-O-L-D, gold. But what is the symbolical representation of this gold is called as a AU. So here the AU is called as a, so Latin name, that is called as a RM. So thank you everyone. So this is my first episode, and the next episode I will say the remaining all subtopics. So thank you very much.